state the second principle of mathematical induction. So let P of n be a statement. Let's consider a mathematical statement involving the natural number n such that P of 1 is true. Second, P of k plus 1 is true whenever P of m is true for all 1 less than or equals to m less than or equals to some k. Then P of n is true for every natural number. This is called second principle of mathematical induction. So this principle states that, so for any mathematical statement, first if we can prove it for n is equal to 1, if we can prove for n is equal to 1, this is true. Then let us assume that for some k, 1 less than or equals to m less than or equals to k, means whatever the numbers which are less than k, it is true. So we'll assume that it is, the given statement is true for every numbers, for every number which is less than or equals to k. Then we have to prove for P of k plus 1. We need to prove for P of k plus 1, and then we can say that this statement is true for every natural number. So here k can be considered like k is less than n. So for 1 less than or equals to m less than or equals to k, and we have to prove that P of k plus 1 is true. So let us see this by taking an example. If a plus b is equal to c plus d and a square plus b square is equal to c square plus d square, then show by mathematical induction a power n plus b power n is equal to c power n plus d power n. So let us consider this as a statement P of n. A power n plus b power n is equal to c power n plus d power n, where n is a natural number. And it's clearly given that a plus b is equal to c plus d, that is for 1. A plus b is equal to c plus d. For n is equal to 1, it is true. And now, also given a square plus b square, that is for 2. A square plus b square is equal to c square plus d square. For n is equal to 2 is also given. It's correct. Now from this both, a plus b is equal to c plus d and a square plus b square is equal to c square plus d square. So the first one, if I do squaring on both sides, a plus b whole square is equal to c plus d whole square. So we had a square plus b square plus 2 times ab is equal to c square plus d square plus 2 times cd. And since we know a square plus b square is equal to c square plus d square from the second, so we can write here 2 times ab is equal to 2 times cd, or we can also conclude that ab is equal to cd. So let us write it here, so which implies ab is equal to cd also, one step. Now for 1 less than or equals to m less than or equals to k, so P of k is true. The statement P of m is true, we can say. So here n is equal to 2 means which is less than or equals to k. So P of 2 is also true. And now we have to consider for P of k plus 1, it is true. So which implies that P of m is true for 1 less than or equals to m less than or equals to k, that is P of k is true, and P of k minus 1 is also true. Below k, any number. So if P of k is true, so we can write a to the power of k plus b to the power of k is equal to c power k plus d power k. And when P of k minus 1 is true, so that is a to the power of k minus 1 plus b to the power of k minus 1 is equal to c to the power of k minus 1 plus d to the power of k minus 1. Now we prove for k plus 1. So let us consider. And what we have to prove for k plus 1? So a to the power of k plus 1 plus b to the power of k plus 1 equals to c to the power of k plus 1 plus d to the power of k plus 1, we have to prove it. So let us consider a to the power of k plus 1 LHS. a to the power of k plus 1 plus b to the power of k plus 1. So we can write this as a to the power of k into a plus b to the power of k into b. So to utilize all these given equations, let us do some addition and subtraction. A power k into a, so let's write here, plus a power k into b minus a power k into b. And for b power k into b, so let's add and subtract here, b power k into a minus b power k into a. So these are the terms added and subtracted. So from these two terms, we can take out a power k common. So we can write a plus b. And again, from these two terms, we can take b power k common. So that we can write again a plus b. And the remaining terms are like a power k into b. So we can write here a power k minus 1 into a, we can also write ab. And here b power k into a, we can write it as b to the power of k minus 1 into b into a. Just multiplying and dividing with a here, since a power k minus 1 is equal to a power k upon a. And if you multiply with a here, so that you'll get a power k. So here a power k minus 1 into ab, and here b power k minus 1 into ba. So we can take out. So from here, a power k plus b power k into a plus b. And here we can take out common ab. So a power k minus 1 plus b power k minus 1. So which equals to a power k plus b power k, c power k plus d power k, right? A power k plus b power k, c power k plus d power k. And again, a plus b is nothing but c plus d, minus ab is also equals to cd. And then a power k minus 1 plus b power k minus 1 is nothing but c power k minus 1 plus d power k minus 1. So just after simplifying, you can get that c power k plus 1 plus d to the power of k plus 1. So which implies that, so from here we can just conclude that p of our statement, p of k plus 1 is true. So therefore, by the principle of mathematical induction, we can say that our statement p of n is true for every natural number, for n belongs to n. So first we consider for n is equal to 1 and n is equal to 2, it is already given. And for m lies between 1 and k, p of m is true, which implies that p of k can be true, and p of less than k, that is k minus 1, is also true. So we have taken these equations, a power k plus b power k is equal to c power k plus d power k, and a power k minus 1 plus b power k minus 1 is equal to c power k minus 1 plus d power k minus 1. And then we consider for p of k plus 1, that is a power k plus 1 plus b of b power k plus 1. So which cannot be written by adding and subtracting these terms here, a power k into b minus a power k into b, and b power k into a minus b power k into a, for simplification. And also we have taken one more step here, a to the power of k into b, we can write it as, let me explain here, a power k into b, we can write it as a power k upon a into ab, right? So a power, we can write this as a power k minus 1 into ab. So that's what I written here, a power k minus 1 into ab. Similarly for b power k into a also written b power k minus 1 into ab, so that I can take out ab common. So if we can utilize these three equations here, one and the second, and three equations you can utilize here, and we can get it c power k plus 1 plus d power k plus 1, which is true for p of n. P of k plus 1 is true, and so by the principle of second principle of mathematical induction, we can say the given statement is true for every natural number. Okay, right. Thank you.